Unsell, Episode 10, Aftermath Victory. A Sonic the Hedgehog goes to see a non-canon alternate universe fanfic. It's been 2 weeks later now since the situation of Caviar the Dog. Fantasee didn't start to slowly wake up and conscious again. She saw her Auntie Sal looking at her from her right bedside in the hospital bed with some equipment to check her heart rate and all that. Hooked up to her. Good morning, my little acorn. Sally said to her adoptive niece, getting her attention when she spoke up. Fantasee then smiled back at her aunt and giggled a bit. She then saw she had some bandages from gauze rolls here and there on her legs and arms, along with her black eye that has already healed. She then turned her attention back to her aunt and asked her, as her aunt then used the bed's mechanic to lean her up. Her upper bed sitting up straight in almost sitting position. In order for her to not keep looking at her aunt over her chest or lifting a bit, just in case Fantasee is still injured. Hey, Auntie, how long have I been out, and who saved me from the ditch? Her aunt, Sally Acorn, didn't reply back to her questions. However, she also wanted to tell Fantasee her thoughts and feelings on about her and her friends put themselves in danger from going after Caviar and his crew. You've been out for 2 weeks now from being in an unconscious state. The person that saved you isn't a person, but a machine in a robot version of your biological dad. His name is Metal Sonic. I also want to tell you something that I do need to get off my chest, too, that's been bothering me for weeks. I'm glad that you stopped Caviar and his gang from blowing up Station Square and you saved the citizens of Station Square and the whole city's demise. However, I'm not that happy that you put yourselves in harm's way in order to stop Caviar and his crew. Fantasee's smile and expression turned to a shocked and sad one. Sally then continued on with her emotional vent to her by sharing her thoughts and feelings. I understand that what you were doing was something that you and your friends were thinking was right to do. However, you three could have gotten injured or worse, gotten yourselves killed. She said as she then began to cry while talking to her adoptive niece. I sometimes feel like you're trying to look for a fight to start trouble, but I know you're not a troublemaker, Fantasee. Is there a main reason why you fought those people like Alyssa and Caviar and his crew? I can understand standing up for the weak and vulnerable from the old man that Alyssa was attacking, but is there another reason? Main reason for that one too, along with knocking her out unconsciously. Fantasee also began to cry as well too while talking to her aunt, and the emotions have poured out in the room. I knocked out Alyssa because she insulted you and it made me extremely mad from her comment about you. I went after Caviar and his crew along with my friends because I heard that you were shot in the undercover spy gave a name and all before being sent to jail or prison. When they were interrogating her in the library after she was stuck under a big pile of books, and I happened to pass the room with my friends that night and listen to what she said. You and your friends shouldn't eavesdrop on that conversation at all. It's a private interrogation, and it's an official guard business, and you three could have gotten into a lot of trouble, too. I know, and my friends know, too, Auntie. We just don't want anyone else getting hurt or worse since all the guards were busy. I also want to protect you just like you were protecting me, like you're protecting me. Sally and Fantasee have fought and argued as a family before, but she wasn't expecting to hear this from her adopted niece. This came as a shock to Sally, since she since her niece wants to protect and keep her safe too. A good whole minute have passed, as Fancy cried her eyes out, and Sally stood there in shock, surprised, and crying as well too. Auntie, Fantasee said as she broke the silence, since she sees her aunt staring at her with a shocked and surprised expression, while trying to find the words to say while in an emotional and shocked state. After 10 seconds of them staring at each other, Sally then gently took Fantasee's hand and held it as she pulls up a chair and has a heart-to-heart talk with her.
You don't have to protect or defend me at all, Fantasee. You know that we have guards to protect us, she said as her adopted niece wipes
her tears away as she's still upset. She said to her adopted niece as she wipes her tears away as she's still upset.
I know that, but I just don't want to lose you. I feel like you mean a lot to me, and I've grown attached to you since you took me in and adopted me as your niece. I don't want to see you get injured, shot, or worse, get killed by someone or something.
Sally Acorn then went in and gave her a hug as they continued to talk, and Fantasee did the same back after being surprised from the hug out of nowhere for a moment.
I understand, and you won't lose me no matter what. I'm always here for you, and love you no matter what. Since we are a family. Everyone has an opinion on everyone around them, to whether it be good or bad. People are judgmental at times, and we can either choose to ignore them or let them get the best and bar us. I know that you heard stories of my past adventures from an extremely very long time ago with old enemies, but we just got to push them out of our lives, since they are toxic and mean people. Not everyone is gonna like us or want to be our friend or friends, Fantasee. That's just part of life. However, there are still good people out there that would like to be our friends. Please don't listen to people's judgments about me when they don't know me at all very well, or yourself or anyone else. That's your true friends or family. That's not your true friends or family, okay? Sorry, I'm not writing about this one. Okay. Okay, thank you for the advice and knowledge, Auntie. Fantasee said while hugging her aunt in her calming down state of mind. Before they let go of their hugging embrace, Fantasee told her aunt this. I love you, Auntie. I love you too, my little acorn.
As both Sally Acorn and Fantasee are still hugging each other, a few seconds later, the door opened and the doctor came in to let Fantasee release from the hospital.
All right, Your Highness, your niece is ready to be released from the hospital, and I'll give you the...
Is everything okay in here, Your Majesty?
Yes, everything is okay, Doctor. Me and my niece were just having a aunt and niece family conversation. You can send me the bill and I'll pay for it.
Sally told the doctor as both her Fantasee and her held hands for comfort after letting each other go of hugging.
Sounds good, Your Majesty. I'll also let my colleagues know that you said to send the bill. Also, the way out is to your right from this room and straight towards the elevator.
Thank you, Doctor. The doctor then walked up to Fantasee to unhook her from all the equipment so that way she can get ready to leave. After unhooking all the equipment from her, he went out of the room and towards the nurse's station on his left in order to give them some privacy.
As Fantasy changes back into her clothes from her hospital gown in the restroom, Sally then waits outside of the restroom for her before they can go home and head to the ceremony later for saving Mobius in Station Square.
Let me get a drink of water real quick. Alright.
Fantasy then asks her Auntie Sal a question regarding who saved her from the ditch and an explosion blast, as she only remembers feeling a metal, a tiny bit from her skin contact to it before completely falling conscious. While she is changing back into her clothes from her hospital gown, "Hey Auntie, who was the robotic metal thing or person that saved my life when I went unconscious?" Sally did got surprised by this question, but at the same time, she was preparing herself for it just in case her niece asked. "The thing that saved you is a robotic copy of your biological dad's Wii. His name is Metal Sonic, and they had a lot of fights and battles here and there back in the old days. He's a creation from Dr. Robotnik to rival and beat Sonic that's supposed to beat him at every turn and fight, but never did. Due to your father destroying him and ruining Dr. Eggman's plans, we fought about destroying and shutting him down for good and permanently, but due to how he saved your life, we feel like this is a completely different Metal Sonic that came from the same universe that you came from, too. It looks like he was ordered by Dr. Eggman to protect you at all costs, no matter what. He's at the castle in the basement from where Nicole and the others and our scientists are converting him to the good side in case he does turn evil again." After Sally finished explaining about the story and history between Sonic and the Hedgehog and Metal Sonic, Fantasy then unlocked the restroom and walked out and back into her original clothes. Sally then smiled and complimented her. "You look very beautiful in blue, my little acorn." "Thank you, Auntie. You look very beautiful and gorgeous yourself, too." "You're welcome, and thank you for the compliment, Fantasy." "You're welcome, Auntie." Fantasy then sat the hospital gown on the bed and walked out of the room with her aunt as they headed for the elevator. When they got on the elevator, Fantasy then asked her aunt one more question as the elevator is going down on the main floor. Going down to the main floor. "Hey, Auntie, This just came to me as an idea, but can I please have Metal Sonic as a companion if that's okay with you and my biological dad?" she asked, and her aunt then responded to her question once the elevator got near the main floor. "Sure thing, but let's first fix him up and fully convert him to the good side. We also need to ask your father, too, as well, if he's okay with it, too, alright?" "Yes, Auntie." The elevator then dinged and they headed towards the desk to pay for Fantasy's hospital medical bills and head home after that to get ready for the ceremony. It's been a few hours now and it's around 7 p.m. Both Fantasy and Sally Acorn have finally arrived to the ceremony event to celebrate Fantasy and her friend's heroism for saving both the Acorn Kingdom and Station Square. They both then walked on the red carpet together, holding hands, since Fantasy is nervous and is not a big fan of being in front of a huge crowd and looking at her since she has stage fright. However, Fantasy still kept a smile on her face as she is waving to the people while in her nervous state. Sally, on the other hand, is waving confidently back at the crowd as she is friendly smiling. They then got inside and went backstage to either put on makeup, hang out with other people, or just wait until it's time to go on stage. Fantasy saw her friends, Tony and Hazel, hanging out at one of the tables, and they noticed her, too, walking in through the door. "Fantasy! Tony! Hazel!" The friends then ran towards each other in the middle of the room and hugged tightly, as Fantasy is relieved and very happy to see her friends okay. Tony and Hazel are relieved and very happy to see their friend Fantasy is okay. We thought you were gone for good since you've been out for a while. We are very happy to have you back, Fantas. Now, I'm glad to be back and got to know that you both are safe and sound. The three friends then went back to the table that Hazel and Tony were hanging out at to sit down, to hang out and catch up on things that Fantasy missed while she was unconscious in the hospital. Sally, on the other hand, decided to go sit at another table to just scroll through her phone and look at social media and all while the three girls are catching up together. A few minutes later, Sonic the Hedgehog and his friends walked into the same room that Sally and the girls are in, Guy are in. Well, it's pretty cool and epic that three young adults or teenagers have stopped the villain that we have been trying to trace for months now. I don't like how they put themselves in harm's way, but it shows how really brave these kiddos were, babe. Heck, I even heard one of them looks like Sonic stopped what he was about to finish saying when he turned facing forward and saw a light or sky blue hedgehog that looks like him but different. Fantasy also looked at her biological father first before he saw her, and even though she's from a different universe, she still considers him her dad, even though they just seen each other in person. Amy, Rose, Tails, and Knuckles then went to go over and sit by Sally, Acorn, as they know now silently watch both Fantasy and Sonic meet in their juicy chair in person. Hello, I'm Sonic the Hedgehog. Hey, and nice to meet you, Sonic. I'm Fantasy the Hedgehog. Both hedgehogs are stumped and not sure what else to say to each other, but Sonic then broke the silence when he asked, "How have you been, Fantasy?" "I'm doing good. How about you, Fantasy then covered her mouth in embarrassment as her eyes widened after almost calling Sonic her dad. Sonic was also shocked and surprised along with everyone else in the room that was also watching and listening to her conversation. Fantasy then broke the silence this time and apologizing to Sonic, and then they began to talk things out as father and daughter. I'm so very sorry, Sonic. I didn't mean to call you my dad." "It's okay, Fantasy. I actually secretly know that you're my daughter, too, since Tails has shown me in Ames the lab results from the papers that Sal sent through to his email, along with other stuff about you too." "Oh, I see. I wasn't sure if you would accept me as your daughter since I'm not from this universe, since I was brought here from Dr. Eggman that somehow helped me escape an evil entity, and one part of my DNA is from whoever that monster is." Sonic then put his hand on her shoulder and told her his thoughts as she then looked up at him in the eyes. "Listen, Fantasy, when I at first heard that you're my biological daughter, I had a really hard time accepting the fact and wrapping my head around it to figure it out, since I never have went to adult city, quote unquote, with any other gal except Amy. Heck, she knows that too, and she was worried at first. However, we realized that you're from a different universe from the one that we are in right now. It took us a while to accept the facts, but we soon did. Heck, we even had a daughter of our own that's 2 years younger from you, and you could possibly be her older sister. What I'm trying to say is that I don't care if you're a half EXE or anything else, as long as you're a good person that will rather not physically hurt those around you, or bring death to anyone. I didn't add that in, but I didn't put that in, but for the script, but I just added words. But it was around you. You're still my daughter, and I accept you for who you are. And Sonic then gave her a hug, as Fantasee then hugged him back. Amy Rose and Sonic's friends, along with Sally Acorn and Fantasee's friends now, then joined in on the hug to make it a group hug to show Fantasee that they accept her for who she is. Later on, it became time for them to go on stage and get the Badge of Honor for saving both the Acorn Kingdom and Station Square. As both Sonic and Fantasee and her friends stand in the middle on stage together, Sonic's friends stood on the left side of the stage watching, along with Fantasee's friends and her friends' friends stood on the right side of the stage watching too. As the honorary person came out with the lanyard badges and he handed them to Sonic. Sonic then gave the first two to Tony and Hazel. As he then got to Fantasee, he put the lanyard badge around her neck by himself and told his half-biological daughter while looking at her, "I'm so very proud of you and happy to call you my daughter." They both then hugged and looked at the crowd as everyone cheered and celebrated the ceremony for the three friends from saving both a city and a kingdom. They also started to set off some fireworks early since the 4th of July is on Monday. Everyone hanged out while Fantasee caught Sonic and Amy Rose up on her own ventures while everyone is partying and having fun. The next few weeks of the rest of the month before July ends, Sally Acorn and her niece then began to hang out more often before she and her friends leave for college somewhere in the middle of August. They went to a lot of fun places together over the month with them, going to the carnival, the arcade, laser tag, watched a movie in a movie theater together, went to the Tin Rack Park concert, and many more fun stuff. However, Sally has been holding a secret from her adopted niece that she is slowly dying from the infection inside her from the bullet wound from that night back in June of when Caviar shot her in the left side. They got the bullet wound out and all, but the lead poisoning was slowly killing her from the inside. On a week before August begins of July, both Fantasee and Sally were about to have their picnic on top of a hill as the sun is about to set, when Fantasee noticed that her auntie is falling behind when she just sat the picnic basket down on a table at the gazebo, overlooking almost the whole Acorn Kingdom. She then looked back down the steps that she looked down to see that her auntie is about to collapse on the stairs halfway, while her holding her left side as it looks like she is in excruciating pain and having a hard time trying to stand on her feet. "Auntie!" Fantasee yelled out to her aunt as she then started to lay on the stairs. She then rushed her to the hospital and waited to see if the doctors can save her still. A few hours later, as Fantasy's friends came by to comfort her, the doctor told her that she won't be able to save her this time and that they tried everything that they can. He then showed them to Sally's room in order to say their goodbyes before she goes, as she doesn't have very long now. The friends then entered her room to find her hooked up to machines along with some pictures on the wall from now how bad an infection looks from the inside out. It shows a bruised texture on her left side, but more darker with some of it stretching out a bit from the directions the infection is going. This then made them more worried as they know it's extremely bad. Fantasee then walked up to her aunt that's barely clinging to life and fighting the infection as she has time to talk to her adopted niece before going. "Hey, auntie. Hey, my little acorn. Why didn't you tell me that the infection is still in your system, auntie? I really don't want you to leave me. Sally then took her niece's hand and held it in hers in order to comfort her while telling her the reason why. I didn't want to scare or worry you in any way, since I don't want to see you stressed or upset. I thought that I could fight it, but it seems to be fighting me back and taking a toll on me. Before I go, I want you to remember that I love and care about you and everyone else too. Auntie, please don't say that. You're gonna make it through and we will be able to go home together. Sally then brings Fantasee in closer to her face as she then gives her a kiss on the cheek, and Fantasee does the same back, as well as her final words left her voice. I will always be here with you in spirit. I love you, my little acorn. She says she passes away in the heart monitor, beat monitor flatlines. Fantasee then cries into her own arms at the end of the bed as her friends Tony and Hazel comfort her next and cries with her too. A funeral was held 2 days later as everyone appeared, including Fantasee and her friends too, along with Sonic and his friends as well. After a lot of comfort and crying all night from the loss of Sally Acorn, as everyone comforted and hugged one another, Fantasee wasn't able to sleep at all that night as the next day comes by for Fantasee, Hazel, and Tony to leave for college and say their goodbyes to family and friends. As they head out of the kingdom, of the Acorn Kingdom, Hazel and Tony didn't know that this will take a very extremely long time for their friend to heal, but they will be there to comfort her and support her the best that they can, as Fantasee does for everyone too. The end of the series.